Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we are going to learn about epiphagus, or say epiphagus. So it's another name, I don't know, continuating name, orobanke, or commonly called as beach drop. So it's according to Borix Materia Medica. So let's get started. A remedy for sick, neurasthenic and nervous headaches, especially in women, brought on or made worse by exertion, shopping, etc. So it's a self-explanatory sentence, and it's commonly indicated in headaches, and that too, which are triggered or say which are made worse by exertion, any kind of exertion, physical or mental. And example of such activities given as shopping. So shopping is really a dehydrating thing, and say, you know, most of the time we don't have food, and you know, we forget to take food, and we are stressed to select what kind of thing we have to choose, and you know, there's a lot of confusion going on. So it's definitely a stressful task. So definitely it will have some kind of physical side effects at the end of the shopping. So we can think of epiphagus in such scenarios, and I've seen literally magic being done with this remedy. And the tongue is very much yellow coated, and there is a kind of bitter taste. So sometimes headache, if they have gastrointestinal correlation as well, presentation will be having some kind of GIT symptoms as well, in the form of nausea, vomiting, which is a migraineous presentation, of course. But not all the time there will be a kind of, you know, very severe GIT symptoms. It may be sometimes having some kind of bitter taste, you know, some kind of uneasiness going on. So in such scenarios, we can think of epiphagus. And there is drowsiness, and generally after meals, you know, some kind of heaviness and loose stools. So GIT is also disturbed along with the nervous headaches. And there is some involution with painful menstruation and congestion. This is entirely a different aspect, but it is given in italics. That's why I'm stressing on the point. So subinvolution, which is a kind of uterine condition, structurally there is change in the axis of the uterus. It is called as subinvolution. You can refer your gynec text for understanding, proper understanding as well. So in such conditions, if there is painful menstruation and congestion, we can think of epiphagus. Coming to the head, there is pressing pain in temples from without inwards. So from outside to inside, there is headache, pressing headache, and which is worse towards the left side, left-sided headaches mostly. And there is thick or say viscid salivation, constant inclination to spit. So this is a very characteristic symptoms. If the headache is accompanied by a constant inclination to spit or say excessive salivation, we can think of epiphagus. Sick headaches which come on when deviating from ordinary pursuits. So as I already said, if headache is triggered by doing something which are not done on a daily basis and which is very much draining both physically and mentally, if such activities trigger headache, we can think of epiphagus. Headaches from nerve tire caused by mental or physical exhaustion preceded by hunger. So this is a very common headache, but very, very sick headache, and it is very much acute remedy and can thought of with a very, very precise action and say very good relief as well. And the modalities are worse from working in open air and better from sleep. So rest generally gives relief. We can think of epiphagus to avoid such kind of headaches. And it should be compared with iris, melilotus, sanguinaria and phagus, because these are also remaining headache drugs. I would like to give a brief comparison here only. In iris, again, there is excessive salivation and GIT symptoms are almost present, and vomiting does not relieve any kind of headache. So it's mostly sick and tired headaches along with GIT symptoms, and we can think of it when there is salivation, excessive amount, and also migraineous headaches as well. Coming to the Melilotus alba is generally hemorrhagic one as well. So some kind of hemorrhage from nostrils generally leave headache, that is seen in Melilotus. And coming to the sanguinaria, it is a right-sided neuralgic headache and accompanied by nausea. And generally sleeping in, sleeping gives them, or with the head high, will give them relief according to Borix Materia Medica. And phagus is something which I'm referring for the first time. I'll go through the remedy and share if any important points I come across in further comparison. So it is given here only, sorry. Headache and salivation, swelling of the mouth, and there is also dread of water. So again, all these headaches are accompanied by, salivation or say GIT symptoms mostly. That brings me to the end of this video. And again, in phagus, there is dread of water as well. So that is very, very prominent. dominant and which is seen in hydrophobinum. So that is because it is a very prominent symptom, hydrophobia, which is seen in rabies. Persons affected with rabies, this kind of symptom is commonly seen. So yeah, that brings me to the end of this podcast. So thanks a lot for listening to this podcast. Hope this podcast was helpful. If so, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Till then.